And it continues. I guess I'm feeling a little hungry. I better get something to eat before it's nighttime. I should head to the dining hall then, I guess. Alright, it's nighttime now. Let's go see what's happening in the dining hall. Everything's quiet. Is there anyone here? Okay, so that's Celeste and Chihiro to talk to.
Oh.
Well there. Good evening. Celeste, what are you up to? What am I up to? I'm simply going for a nice evening stroll. You know, I was thinking about the rooms belonging to everyone who has left us. I would very much like to know what is going on in there, but it seems their doors are locked. It must be another one of Monokuma's little tricks. Sometimes he gets hung up on the weirdest stuff.
I wonder about that.
Do you think so? It seems that it's merely him displaying his passion toward the production of this killing game. Interesting word choice by her part, towards the production of this word of this game. Anyway, I shall resume my excursion. If you have some time, you are welcome to join me. That's okay.
I hope you are well.
Yes, very well then. Goodbye. Okay, good conversation with Celeste, I think. And Achihiro.
Makoto.
Hi, Makoto. This is the warehouse, right? Deka said it had everything we could need, but... Are you looking for something? You need some help?
Huh?
No, I can take care of it myself.
Thank you.
Thank you for asking, though. So then... I wonder what she's looking for. Yeah, well, that was a bit mysterious of her. She didn't tell us what she was trying to do. There is some food stuff in there. But for now, I think I'll just head to the dining hall. I'm in the mood for something fresh. The dining hall has plenty of ready ingredients. Alright, let's just go to the dining hall then. So we have Celeste out for an evening stroll, and I don't know what Chihiro's up to. I just wanted to get something to eat. And now I'm about to get roped into something like this. Actually, no. I guess I'm already roped in.
Listen to me!
Hey, Makoto, perfect timing. Huh? What's going on?
Hey, damn it!
I have a favor to ask. A favor? I have a bad feeling about this. Who should I talk to first? Well, he talked to me first.
Listen to me!
You came at just the right time. I must ask for your full cooperation. Okay, Mondo.
Hey, damn it!
Come on, Makoto. You gotta be our witness. Witness to what?
What?
This guy's been talking shit about me since day one, calling me a coward and shit like that.
You're corrupt!
You are a coward. That's why you turn to violence to solve your problems.
You!
That's why you can't do what society asks of you, or you walk around dressed like that.
Huh?
The fuck you say? You don't know shit.
You hear me?
You already lost to yourself. But you're such a coward, you don't even realize it.
Damn you!
So what? So you're saying you're not a coward? You think you're tougher than me?
Count on it!
I know I am.
You wanna fight?
Okay, then let's throw down. Prove you got what I don't.
You hear me?
I accept your challenge.
What?
So that's what's happening, Makoto. You gotta be our witness. You're gonna throw down? You're not gonna, like, start punching each other, are you?
Hey.
There's a bathhouse on the first floor of the dorm, right? with a sonar inside?
I see.
I see. A simple endurance test, is it?
Got it.
We're going to see who can stay in the sauna the longest, am I right?
Piece of shit!
Goddamn straight. Are you guys really gonna go through with this?
Stop fucking around.
Shit yeah. Yo! Who the fuck says shit yeah? He'll be done in a matter of minutes anyway. People like him are, without exception, all talk.
You wanna throw down?
Bring it on. Hell, let's make things more interesting. Wouldn't want to win without a challenge, right? Interesting?
You son of a bitch.
We're gonna battle with all our clothes on.
Ridiculous.
That's idiotic. Suicidal.
You wanna fight?
Why, you afraid? You're going to regret this.
Stop fucking around.
Shut up and let's do this.
Hey, Mondo.
What, asshole?
You can take off your uniform, you know? Go ahead. I won't judge.
And you can shut the fuck up and mind your own business. I mean, look at you.
Why does Mondo have, like, a little towel on his hair? And Taka looks like he's taking a shit. And you can shut the fuck up. Yes, yes, yes.
Your face is all red. What are you, one of those goddamn hot spring monkeys?
It just so happens, I was born with a red face.
You don't have to act all big, man.
Act, you say? I'm still plenty good to go. I'm so good, I could eat a steaming hot bowl of soup right now.
I'll go make your steaming hot bowl of soup. Don't worry, Taka. Are they okay? Makoto, they are not okay. Like, mentally. I tried to push my concern aside. A few minutes passed. Then a dozen minutes. Then an hour. Okay, they're dead.
Don't you think it's about time you gave up?
What about you? You can't even hardly talk. Dumbass.
Say whatever you want. I'm still totally good to go. In fact, I'm starting to feel kind of cold.
Taka, that's not good. If you're out in the middle of like the desert and you start to feel cold, that usually means that, yeah, you're about to die.
That's probably not good.
Yeah, exactly. Guys, I know you both want to prove how big and badass you are, but don't you think you've done enough?
Shut up!
I guess I can't win.
This is a school announcement. It is now 10 p.m. As such, it is officially nighttime. Soon the doors to the dining hall will be locked, and entry at that point is strictly prohibited. Okay then. Sweet dreams, everyone. Good night. Sleep tight. Don't let the bed bugs bite.
Thank you, Monokuma. Hey, do you hear that? It's nighttime. How about we call it a tie?
In a true competition, there's no such thing as a tie. You win or you lose. That's the only thing that matters.
Listen to you, you son of a bitch. Then bring it on. I'll push you right up to the gates of hell.
They have such serious faces. The gates of hell? That's not a good place to push someone. Why would that be your reaction, Makoto? This isn't good, guys. Yeah, you hear him? Bear crawl on back. to your room. I'll let you know how it went in the morning. Then you can start spreading my legend. Come tomorrow morning. You'll fall down in front of me. Down on your knees. I'll show you where to do it. Big talk from someone whose face is about to explode. Right back at ya. Okay, well, good night then. See, Mikoto, you should have done that like an hour ago. I really hope those two don't overdo it. But I'm sure to the death. No, surely they wouldn't go that far. The concern stayed with me as I slowly succumbed to sleep. I don't know how they didn't get in trouble. They like broke Monokuma's rule about not being out late. If fate does exist, does that mean your future is decided the moment you're born? No, it would mean your future is decided before you're even born. Gotcha, Monokuma. If all your yesterdays pile up to create your tomorrow, is your future as final as your past? I just don't know.
That's why I'm still alive! Because I don't know! That's why I desperately cling to life!
Thanks, Monokuma. I really needed that.
Good morning, everyone! It is now 7 a.m. and nighttime is officially over. Time to rise and shine! Get ready to greet another beautiful day!
Morning, huh? I hope Mondo and Taka survived. And it'll be quieter with them gone. Okay, that's fucked up. Worried about the two of them, I hurry to the dining hall more quickly than usual. And when I entered... What are you talking about, bro? What are you talking about, bro? Oh my god, they're broken. What the...
Yo.
Hey, Mikoto. Thank you so much for acting as our witness yesterday. Are they friends now? They've been like this all morning. They were all buddy-buddy as soon as I walked in. It feels gross.
What?
Feels gross? Hell no. Feels great, more like it. Ooh. This almost feels like sexual harassment somehow. Forget her, bro. A girl like her just doesn't get our manly bond.
You hear me?
Friendship between men is stronger than blood, and women could never understand.
Ain't that right?
What you just said, bro? That was cool as shit. I should get a tattoo of it. Oh my god. No, bro, you mustn't. Your body is a temple, given to you by your loving parents. So, who won the contest?
Piece of shit!
Who gives a shit?
Got it!
Yeah, don't ask stupid questions. What matters is that we both took part in it together. That's completely different from what you were saying last night.
I see.
Friendship between men seems very simplistic. Nothing like what I'm used to with girls. Yeah, for real. And so, the high school drama continues. All throughout breakfast that morning, the room was dominated by Mondo and Taka's overpowering brotherhood. All in all, it was a pretty unfortunate experience. So what should I do today? Who could that be? Wondering who had come to visit, I opened the door and someone forced their way in. What? Of all the people in the world to come into my room, I would never expect it to be Toko. Toko? What's the matter?
What's your problem?
I love her way of talking. Why are you so surprised? Am I really that annoying? Well, I already know I'm annoying. I came here knowing that, so that makes it okay. Not really. No, you're not annoying. I just wondered what was going on. I have a favor to ask. I want you to go somewhere with me. And where is it you want to go?
Well,
the library. Are you looking for a book or something? Man, oddly enough, I just had a dream last night where I had to return a book to the library, but I couldn't find it. What a weird dream to have. Like, there was a high school library and everything, and I haven't been in school in 10 years, so what a weird dream I had. Anyways, why don't you just ask Byakuya? He spends all his time in the library anyway. Did I say something wrong? You're not a blabbermouth, right? This has to be a secret. I honestly have no idea what you're talking about, but if you want me to be quiet, I'll be quiet. Then let's just go to the library. I got it, the library. Why is she so pushy? Quiet, be quiet when you go in. Don't let him see you. She actually was starting to get annoying, but I did what she said and gently crept into the library. Unsurprisingly, Byakuya was there by himself, absorbed in a book.
He's here! Oh, he's really here! Okay, Makoto, go talk to him!
What the fuck is going on?
What? Stop being so loud! Just hurry up and go talk to him!
You go talk to him if you want to so bad.
I can't. I don't want to interrupt him.
That's kind of crazy. I guess let's talk to... Actually, there might be coins here. I have 0 coins. Hold on. Alright, no coins in here, unfortunately.
What the heck?
Come on, just talk to him. Oh, let's talk to him. He seems to really be focused on the book. It doesn't seem like the best time to talk to him. Hey, you. What are you doing back here? I hate even having to look at you. So you noticed me, huh?
Naturally.
Of course. Now hurry up and leave. And take her with you. Byakuya? Remember how you said, don't be a woman who dominates weak men. Be a woman dominated by a strong man. I never said that. Well, actually, I just thought it sounded like something you might say. Get out. And go take a bath. You smell.
Don't make me repeat myself.
Don't make me say it again. Go now before your stench latches onto the entire room. Damn. Are you okay, Toko? That was kind of mean. He really dug into us there. Maybe he's in a bad mood. She seems super depressed. Did he really upset her that much? Byakuya, to go that far? He must really be concerned about me. He told me to take a bath and everything. He must really care about my well-being. Hey, Makoto, what do you think? Whoa, 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 don't ask me. Yo, I don't know. I don't know. Think of Think about what? Do you think Bibiakya and I would be good together? Maybe? Well, now, I don't really know.
Maybe.
That's true. There's really no way to know. But the distance between us doesn't change our love. Yes, it does. Because as soon as you realize your feelings, the love is born. That's how love works. There might come a day when you understand. Maybe, someday. Bye. Young love. Ba-bum, ba-bum. Who would have ever guessed you would go for someone like him? But eager passion can also be scary. Sometimes that leads people off in the wrong direction. All of a sudden, I feel exhausted. Maybe I'll head back to my room for a while. There's still some time left in the day. What to do? Alright, who should I hang out with now? I think, let me see. I think I should finish off Chihiro. I wonder how that teddy bear actually operates. Could it be a robot with an AI installed in it? No, we don't have that technology yet. Maybe it's some kind of bear-shaped cyborg from the future. Should I hang out with Chihiro for a while? You want to sit down and talk for a while? I spent some time talking with Chihiro. Chihiro and I grew a little closer today. Would you like to give Chihiro a present? Alright, what do we have here? Maybe I should just give curry. No. I'm keeping the curry. Bird seed. So I don't really know why Chihiro would like a red scarf. Maybe. A scarf belonging to a certain masked hero is tattered and worn due to countless battles it's been through.
Huh?
I can have this? Thank you. This has made me feel a little better. Does that mean she liked it? If you don't hate the idea, would you like to talk some more? If there's anyone who can say no to someone who asks like that, I'd like to meet them. Sure, I'd love to learn more about you. Okay, but what do you want to know? Let's see. What kind of program are you working on now? Yeah, I bet it's pretty amazing. Well, how could she be working on a program right now? She's trapped in here, right, Makoto?
You know?
Actually, I just started a research process for something. You remember that database software I told you about? I'm retooling it into something a little more complex. But I signed an NDA with the company that hired me, so I can't really go into the details. Yeah, they probably wouldn't want the wrong people to hear about it, huh?
I'm sorry.
It's not that I don't trust you or anything. I just made a promise, you know? Sorry. It's okay. It's my fault for asking about something you couldn't talk about. But maybe I can give you a little hint. It has to do with simulating human thoughts. She said it has to do with simulating human thoughts, right? Which must mean virtual reality. Nah, artificial intelligence. You're developing some kind of artificial intelligence, aren't you? You figured it out. Was my hint too easy?
What should I do?
What am I gonna do? If they find out I broke my promise, they might... Don't worry, I'm not gonna say anything to anyone. I know I can trust you. I guess I can tell you about it.
You know?
I'm working on a type of artificial intelligence the world has never seen before. It's what we call a strong AI. It's designed to think like a human, to process any mental tasks we can. A strong AI? You see, in the field of artificial intelligence, this strong AI and weak AI, this is true, guys, this is true. Weak AI isn't meant to match human intelligence. It's simply a type of problem-solving software. A weak AI isn't actually thinking, it's just executing actions programmed into it. Strong AI, on the other hand, is a program that can achieve through self-consciousness, full ego awareness. In other words, a strong AI is a complete entity, a computer program capable of becoming aware. But it's always just been a hypothesis. Plenty of experts don't think it's even possible. It sounds like something from a sci-fi movie, and you're working on something like that?
But...
Well, like I said, right now I'm just researching it. I've made a lot of progress on the programming side, and the intelligence development. But when it comes to actual awareness, it's still a long way off. It might even be impossible. Really?
You know?
I'm not sure how to put it, but no matter how well designed or complex a program is, no matter how closely the software can simulate the workings of the human brain, I don't think that's enough. If the program is only simulating thought, it will always be lacking something.
Yeah.
Well, I guess you could say a soul. If you could somehow pour your own soul into software, maybe then a strong AI could be created. A soul? I know, it's not a programming term. I'm not even sure how that would work on a technical level. Well, in Ghost in the Shell, the anime, like there is the concept of like, you know, well, the ghost in the shell, like the soul in the machine. Sorry, forget I mentioned it.
You know?
All I have right now is a theory. There's still a lot of research left to do. Artificial intelligence sounds like a pretty tough subject, but I'm glad I got to hear about it. I wasted your time on another boring topic. I must have bored you to death, huh? The complete opposite. It was really interesting.
Huh?
You mean it?
Yay!
Okay, next time we talk, I want to hear about you. Unlike you, I really am boring. No excuses. It's your turn next time. Okay. Yay! When she says it like that, I think the only way to refuse is if you're one of those soulless AI programs she mentioned. Chihiro's report card has been updated based on your experience with her. Your maximum number of skill points has increased. Hey, look at you go. Once we're all done, I headed back to my room.